What about the mercury in seafood? Well, let's start with understanding how mercury actually harms our health, because I think that's really important for this discussion. So the form of mercury that we actually need to be concerned with is called methylmercury. Methylmercury is an organic form of mercury produced by bacteria when they encounter elemental mercury in their environments. And the reason why it's so harmful is both that it bioaccumulates, meaning it builds up in environments and ecosystems, and also because it's much more likely to interact with our biology. So methylmercury is 17 to 35 times more absorbable in our gastrointestinal tracts than elemental mercury. And the way that it harms us is by binding nearly irreversibly to selenium. Now, we have a variety of different selenium-based proteins in our body called selenoproteins or selenoenzymes when they have enzymatic activity. And it just so happens that 25 to 30 of these different selenoenzymes are really important antioxidant enzymes that protect our central nervous system. So they are there to make sure that our brain doesn't suffer oxidative damage. Well, when mercury binds with the selenoenzymes, these selenoenzymes can no longer do their normal function. And what ends up happening is the buildup of neurological damage, which can manifest as a variety of different symptoms. That's where the term mad as a hatter comes from. It comes from oldie timey hat manufacturers using mercury to treat the felt and these chronic exposure to mercury building up in their systems over time, such that mercury poisoning was really commonly found in hatters. So, do we need to avoid seafood because of mercury contamination? The answer most of the time is no. Seafood tends to be one of our best food sources of selenium, and this is important for two reasons. As long as there's more selenium in that fish than methylmercury it's been exposed to, which varies depending on the waters that that fish lives in, then that fish's selenium is already bound to the methylmercury that fish was exposed to. That means that that methylmercury cannot interfere with our selenoenzymes. It's basically harmless to us. This is actually measured in scientific research as something called the selenium health benefit value. It's basically a ratio of selenium to mercury in fish and shellfish found in waters throughout the world. Only top predators in polluted waters tend to have more mercury than a selenium. So we're talking about shark, pilot whale, and swordfish, but only in some waters, not in all waters. Those are the only fish that we would want to moderate or avoid. So it even makes fish and shellfish an even more valuable food because the selenium it contains helps to protect us against mercury toxicity from other sources.